This is the word of God's grace brought to you by the Standing Church International. We're a life-transforming church with a vision of raising a supernatural army for the Lord. Get ready to be blessed by God's word and experience miracles.
Rising above weakness. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 14 to 16. For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his Spirit in the inner man. Isaiah chapter 35, verse 3 to 4. Strengthen ye the weak hands, and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. Even God with a recompense. He will come and save you. God will save you on this mountain. These opening scriptures, sometimes you should just go and spend time in them. Meditate on them. Psalm 27, verse 1 to 14. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Manage expectations. The way people live the Christian life is as if nothing bad can happen around them. But this man says, though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, are you in trouble? He shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies. They are round about, but my head will be lifted. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yes, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Yea, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou sayest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. When God talks, there must be a response. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not. Thank God in the New Testament, he says, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. Ah, so we can boldly say it now that we know your face is not far from us. We know that just like the waters of Noah, you will never be angry with us. Now you have been our help and we know you will not leave us. Neither will you forsake us. Oh God of our salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. There's nobody that can be closer to you or that should be closer to you than this set of people in function, in role that they have played. When this happens with them, at all or not, he says that is when God picks me up. That means that my hope is not in man. And then he goes ahead and says, teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not over to the will of my enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me. Maybe this is what is happening in your workplace. And such as breathe out cruelty, I will have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. There is a siege of weakness around today, because demonic forces have been unleashed to weaken the hands of God's people. I'm not talking about physical weakness and sickness. I'm talking about mental weakness. And this thing is a sign of the end times. It is easy for you to be distracted and think it's because you have a lot to do. That's why you're tired. It would have been okay if you were tired because you had a lot to do. But how about now that you cannot even stand up to do anything because your mind is tired? It's a sign of the end times. Because Jesus said in Luke 21 that there shall be distress of nations upon the earth with perplexity, the seas and the waves roaring, the hearts of men failing them for fear and for looking after those things that are coming on the earth. Does this explain what a lot of us are going through? I'm not going through it, but it's not as if I've not been there before. I can give you answers because it says that blessed be the God of our comfort, who comforts us so that we can comfort those that go through their own tribulation. So we are not preaching to you like people that are perfect, who have never had any problem. We are telling you that we remember how our God has never failed us. We remember how his name has made a way. So we are coming to declare the same name unto you. So Jesus said, the heart of men shall fail them for the fear of what is coming upon the earth. It's not just for what is coming, for looking after it. Because what is making you afraid is not what is happening, it's what you are seeing, what you are looking at. For every sight that is negative that you catch, or every negative thought that comes to your mind, there's an evil spirit by you to ensure that it enters your heart. So if you continue looking at obituaries up and down, say people are just dying anyhow, there's a spirit of death that is standing there to ensure that thing jumps on you. Then suddenly you just find out that you are moody. Suddenly you just find out that you start losing interest in previously enjoyed activities. Then you look around, then you read news. $1 has become 3,500 naira. As you shout that A, the spirit of fear is present to press that thing inside. The size and sounds that you make in your darkest times, even though they might be whispers, they are very loud in the realm of the spirit. That's why one of the best things you can do, no matter how bad things feel, is to hold your mouth and speak only when you have the right words to say. Because inasmuch as it is bad to load the chambers of your mind with bad thoughts, it is worse to pull the trigger with bad words. Somebody might not say more than, we don't even know where this country is going to. The next person did not hear you. But in the realm of the spirit, forces are running already. They started moving. So whenever things are happening around and there is that weakness and weariness that wants to jump on you, don't accept it. Otherwise, that evil spirit will stand by you. And you are a Christian. You will now find out why you are tired every day. You will now be wondering why you are hearing the word of God. But it's as if something is sapping your joy. As if something is sapping your strength. You will think it is your workplace people. They are stressing you. You know what that's going to lead to? You will resign from your job. You know what that's going to lead to? You will not have salary. You know what that's going to lead to? You will be hungry. Then your predictions will come to pass. Your mind will not be clear. You'll be making wrong decisions. But today, as I'm speaking, those omens, those evil thoughts, those barrages of the enemy against your mind in this season, they are removed from your mind. Jesus said, there shall be distress of nations upon the earth. That's so strong. What we are seeing around, God has told us it will happen. It's not breaking news. But listen, God is our hope and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be moved. Jesus said that there will be distress of nations upon the earth. But he says, therefore will not we fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Jesus said, the sea and the waves will roar. But this psalm says that, though the waters thereof roar, and though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of the Lord, the tabernacle of the Most High God. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. I like verse 10. Be still and know that I am God. Verse 7 says, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is my refuge. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. Someone said that people say, if he's not chasing something, something is chasing. Don't mind them. We are not running because something is chasing us. He says, flee to the stronghold, ye prisoners of hope. The reason we are fleeing to the stronghold is not because something is chasing us. It's because we have found hope. We are prisoners of hope. That no matter what is going on, we are irredeemable hopers. We know it will always be better. It's because of this that we are holding to that stronghold. God is our hope and strength. He said in Hebrews chapter 6 that we are fled for refuge. He says this hope we have as an anchor for our soul. Without Christ, our forerunner, is run into. We have hope. From today, this God I serve is strengthening your hands. He said, strengthen the weak hands. The marginal rendering says the sinking hands. When we talk about weak hands, it does not just mean that you can't do anything again. You know when what you are doing, your hands are getting weaker on it. Slowly, it is slipping out of your hands. It is going away. You had energy before, but now it is slipping off. It has not yet shown that anything is wrong, but very soon, in front, you will meet the result. It's a strengthening. It's that strength I've come to give you. It's that strength I've brought as God's prophet, that no matter how dark the times are, things are shifting for you. He says, say unto them that are of a fearful heart, be strong. Fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. He will come with a recompense. He will come to save you. Oh God, to whom vengeance belongs. Show yourself. Today, God is showing himself on your behalf. The Lord shall go forth like a man of war. He shall stir up jealousy. He will roar. Yes, he will cry. He will shout. He will prevail against your enemies. On this mountain, this prophetic mountain, God is prevailing against your oppositions. He says, they gathered around me, but in the name of the Lord, I cut them off. Today, those things that have gathered around you, you are cutting them off by the power of God. Those enemies that have run against your businesses, those foes that have run against your businesses, strength is entering into your hands. You are cutting them off. I'm seeing utterance in the mouths of people. It will settle. As you are speaking, things will be happening. I'm seeing people rearranging things with their words. Ezekiel said that the angel of the Lord gave me a scroll and he said, eat it. He said, I ate it. He said, go and speak with my words. There are many of you who have been looking for utterance. God is putting that coal of utterance in your mouth. Strong utterance, that prophecy says, shall proceed out of the mouth of many to calm the storms in families, in cities, and in communities. Strong utterances are coming out of your mouth in this season. As you are speaking, things are shifting. As you are speaking, things are happening. You don't have to be down. You don't have to be weak. You will see it too. Utterance. Utterance of the mighty. I'm seeing you rearrange things without utterance. I'm seeing people taking businesses, speaking, and as they are speaking, they are stacking the businesses up on one another. I'm seeing you handling multiple things at the same time. I'm seeing God putting strength in your hands. Satan will try to keep you in the arena of senses so he can defeat you. Because he has been in this game for a long time. Your only hope is to dwell in the arena of faith. In times like this, because the just shall live by faith. Your only hope is to dwell in the arena of faith. And every time you are trying to sit down in the arena of faith, Satan will come and hold you and drag you out. And make you to start thinking. He say, wait, think about it now. How will you, once you start thinking like that, he will defeat you. Because what the devil is after is your strength. You think Satan is after your salary, that's why they sacked you. He's after your strength. What the devil is after is your faith. He's not after your money. If Satan needs money, he knows what to do now. He's not after your money. You are the one that is the danger to him. Not your money. So if he can take this one out, take this one out. He's not after Job's children. He is after Job's life. So you might see Job's children collapse. You might see Job's business collapse. You might see Job's animals collapse. But at the end of the day, it's to the end that Job will be weak and he will curse God. It's so that you can walk away from your Christian faith. That's what he is after. You must not allow troubles hound you to the place where you lose your hope in God. In one day, it was as if Job lost everything. At once. Striking his heart. Until when he lost everything, the devil said, let us touch his flesh. So that he will curse you. You will see that this man is not faithful to you. God said, but don't touch his life. So Satan does not have power over your life. But he is bringing many other things around you so that you can give up that life. I brought strength to you. I'm strengthening your feeble knees. I'm strengthening your weak hands today. When you try to rise, he will hack you down. That's Satan. When you are moving forward, he will make sure he does something to draw you back. You'll be running fast, sharing testimonies, then suddenly clients will stop coming. You will be trying to speak, he will be trying to shut you up. You see, many of you, what you don't know is that your heads are very high in the realm of the spirit. You are a terror. Is it only me? Is it only me? They don't have as much opposition. If what you are looking for enters your hands, do you know what you will do? Do you know how you will deal with the devil? So there are people that the devil does not send like that. They can be doing anything they want to do. They are not consequential. But you, it must make you weak. Because Paul said that because of the abundance of revelation that was given to me, a messenger of Satan was given to me to buffet me. That because a man is abundant in light, the devil knows that the man that has light is the man that goes up. So it says a messenger of Satan was given to me to buffet me, a thorn in the flesh. He will go into this place. They will carry him. They will throw him inside water. He will go into that place. He was tired until he cried out. He said, Lord, remove this thing from me. But you see, that when a man is going up in the realm of the spirit, the devil is there to make sure that with this light that you have, you don't go up. So this thing that is happening to you, that you are sulking is not the way out. You have to rise up. He will be happy if he breaks that marriage. He will be happy if he breaks that thing that is in front of you. If he fractures your strength and makes sure that you don't rise in your academics, he will be happy. But thank God that we can be strengthened with might by the Spirit of God in our inner man. Thank God that Christ can dwell in our hearts by faith. Thank God that we have a God unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly, far above all we can ask or think of. I'm moving up. Thou hast made my feet like hinds' feet. The Lord my God is causing me to walk upon my high places. This thing that they have been dangling in front of you, that it has been looking for, now you are grabbing it suddenly. The things that have been looking like they have been far away, they have entered your hands too. That certificate, you get it. That course that has been delayed, that delay is broken right now. Your name is appearing on that list. Daniel was praying. He was praying for light. Light was coming from heaven. A demon stood. Not just any demon. A prince over a whole region stood because one man was praying. And he said, the angel from heaven must not pass here. Why? This man must not have light. Light is heaven's greatest commodity. If it is trying to come to you, the devil will try to block you. If it comes to you, he will try to deal with you. So this impression that once I have light, Satan cannot come anywhere around me, is a lie. It's when you have light that it starts coming for you. But thank God. They say put on the whole armor of God that you might be able to withstand. That means that there's no pressure the devil can put that you are not bigger than. Yeah. Having done all to stand, stand therefore. The weapon of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down. So the great news is not that Satan is coming. The great news is that we have been delivered. The great news is that we have authority. But it's not good to have something and not use it. For I have seen princes that are walking like servants. What you are does not change your life until it enters your heart. So many things cause weakness in the heart of believers. One of the major things that causes weakness, unmanaged expectations. Many of you are weak because you have not been managing your expectations. Many people are weak because they've not been managing their expectations. What do we mean by unmanaged expectations? This was what I told God that I wanted. I told him that if he gives me this, I will serve him. But if he does not give me this, I warned him that I will backslide. You warned God. God is bigger than that now. This thing that people think is faith, that they say, God said, concerning the works of my hand, command ye me. That's not what that scripture says. What that scripture is saying is that, will you command me about the works of my hand? Who are you? The way we come to God is with humility of heart. Is with reverence. That this God, we can't command him. He is our Father. Some of you say, I command you in the name of Jesus. Unconsciously. And it's God you are talking to. When you have desires, let your expectations be based on God's word, not on the desire. I'm trusting God for a new car. I'm expecting a new car. No, it's better to say that God has said that any good thing that I seek, I will not lack it. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. Let your faith be anchored on that. Not on the car. Otherwise, if the car does not come, you'll be weak. You can hold on to God's word when you are believing God for a car. And say, no good thing will he lack. The young lions do lack and suffer, but anyone that seeks the Lord will not lack any good thing. Then you will hold on to that, and that revelation will be growing in you like a mighty tree. Then you will get a phone, and you wonder, how did I get this? I didn't even think about the phone, and it came into my hands. Then you'll be like, that means that God is able to. Is that light you use and ascend and just go and pick a car? Yet, you can be saying, I'm looking for a car. Look, I gave God a time. Lord, by so time. You might be discouraged, though. It might not happen. Don't give God timelines. All of you that used to say, Lord, by so time, please do this for me. I know man might have set a deadline. It doesn't mean you should enjoy yourself with their deadline. Don't enjoy yourself. If you don't do this before so and so, you will miss the admission. Is there not next year? People used to do as if missing admission is missing rapture. There is nothing that is not of eternal consequence on this earth that should be able to shake you. The reason you are weak is that you are making what is small big. God is big. But sir, it's my career we are talking about here. It's my career, you see, that's unmanaged expectations. And another major thing is competition. Everybody, they your lane, no. Me, I'm going on my own lane, no. I'm giving God praise on my lane, no. Sir, I know where my mates are by now. This admission that I miss now, I've lost 1 year. I got admission with my own colleagues many years ago now. This thing we are talking about is already like 14 years ago. I had to stay 1 more year because I was not 16. I was 15 and 10 months. I could have added to my age and grown by 1 year. You don't need to do that. But if we miss the admission now, if we have to defer. But if it defers for 2 years, it will rust at home. No, in 2 years, you can become an IT guru. That medicine itself, you might not want to study it again. There is no delay. It is what you do with time that makes things look like a delay. There's no delay. My heart is strong. See, people of God, I thank God I waited that 1 year. Because if I followed that set that I entered with, you will not have a pastor today. Because this fire I caught it in the next set, not that set. This extra year, it might be your wife that you have refused to see in the last 4 years. I'm not saying God gave you the extra year, but there's a bright side to every challenge. One young man in those days, my spiritual father shared this testimony. He's not young again. No. He was in NDA many years when my spiritual father was there and was fellowship president in his set. And then, you know, the next set, no spiritual people there. So they relegated him. That, you know how it will feel as fellowship president. They just relegated. He was sad. But he picked himself up and continued. Then that fire was able to be maintained for that next set till the next set came. God's plan is more than putting one star on your shoulder. They call you second lieutenant. God has something higher than that. There's a Solomon after a child who never did a naming. And that child was not meant to be the king. Solomon became the king. God has a way of seeing things. He's able to turn anything around. Keep your heart in peace. If you have lost anything, God is the reason why you have not lost everything. You say, look at how my husband just left. But are your children not doing well? Is God not helping you? I don't even know where my father is all these years. He never took care of me. Have you not graduated? All this entitlement mentality, it doesn't take people anywhere. You see, your parents are taking good care of you. Do they have a choice? Did I beg to be born? Are there not people that they did not also beg to be born and they gave back to them and threw them on fuse beam because the parents did not have money? Your own parents didn't have the same money. They took care of you. It's the mercy of God. You have many things to look at and be thankful for. If you are not like this, you become weak. Your faith will become weak. Abraham had nothing to thank God for, but only a word. So shall your seed be. If he looked at Sarah, her womb was dead. If he looked at himself, he was dead. Everything that could produce the promise was dead, but the promise. As long as there's a word to you, everything is still alive. So things might look like they are dead, but the word of God is living. Paul said, I might be bound, but the word is not bound. You might be bound, but the word is not bound. He that knows the truth will set him free. Manage your expectations. Rejoice in everything God is doing for you.
What a refreshing time in the word it has been. We believe you've been blessed by God's word and have received encounters for mighty miracles. To download more messages like this one or listen to the full conference message, please visit our website at www.thestandingchurch.com. There you will find an abundance of resources to help you grow in your Christian walk and deliver miracles of destiny to you. We cannot wait to hear your testimonies and we look forward to having you connect with us. Please write to us at info@thestandingchurch.com or call us on +2348 1347 73145, or connect with us via our social media platforms on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube at The Standing Church. If you've never made the decision to be saved and would like to receive Jesus into your life or rededicate your life to Him, please say the following words out loud. Lord Jesus, I confess you as Lord over my life. I believe that you died for me and that God raised you from the dead. I receive all that you have made available for me through your death, burial, and resurrection. I declare right now that I am a child of God. I'm free from sin, and I am the righteousness of God. Amen. Congratulations, you are now saved. We're so glad you made the decision to receive Christ today. Please write to us at +234 813 477 3145 to share your salvation testimony with us today. In or around the city of Ibadan, we invite you to join us at the Dominion Center for each of our services in the week. Join us on Sundays for our worship service by 9 a.m. and our teaching services on Mondays by 5 p.m. Our prayer and communion services on Fridays by 5 p.m. Each of these services are put together to deliver God's word and power to you and bring you into the life of prosperity, health, dominion, and liberty that God has ordained for you. Not in Ibadan? Don't miss out. Our services and special meetings are streamed online via our Mixlr and YouTube platform at The Standing Church. We look forward to having you worship with us. God bless you. We love you and God bless you.